Is Daniel Tosh funny? Let's find out.
It is great to be here in America. The greatest country in the world, if you haven't traveled a lot. Do we have to constantly scream we're number one? It's always the people that live in the most boring parts of this country that scream the loudest.
Quick question. Are you a fan of Daniel Tosh? This is my first time actually reacting to him. Have I heard the name? Yeah, I've heard the name before, but I've never reacted to him on this channel. Have you ever been to a show? If you have, let me know, you know, how the experience was, and tell me what other specials I should be reacting to.
Kansas, we're the greatest country in the world. It's like, do you guys have internet there? You ever seen a photo of feet?
Every time you say something funny. When you hear that go off, he's going the right path.
I've never been to Fiji, but I've seen photos. It looks pretty amazing. It's hard to think we're better than that. We're top 10. Maybe if we started screaming that every day, maybe terrorists would stop trying to saw our heads off. We're top 10.
I love savage comedy. Please write savage in the comments if you love savage comedy. I love it brutal. I like when everybody's offended. I feel like if nobody's offended, it's not real comedy.
And they'd be like, that's fair. It was that number one stuff that was getting old. America's basically turned into one of these factories where we just have a sign up. Like, it's been 22 days since our last horrible thing. And it's like, oh, all right, rip it down. We're back at zero again. These things just keep happening, you know, whether it's Ferguson or Baltimore. I can solve racist cops. That's an easy fix. But nobody comes to me for the answers. You want to get rid of that forever? How about this? Only black people should be allowed to be cops. Boom, problem solved.
Yeah. Now, this is my question. What is your outlook on this? Do you feel like he's right? Do you feel like he's wrong? I mean, I like comedians like this that touch that line. I always talk about touching that line and crossing that line. Some people are scared to say certain things, and some people are not scared to say certain things. So I could respect a guy like him. I like where he's going.
And if any of you have issue with this, it's because you're racist. What about white people? White people can be firefighters. We're more outdoorsy, it makes sense. White people, firefighters, black people, cops. Who wants tickets to the softball game now? Yeah, it's gonna get pretty tense. Might wanna put in a mercy rule. And the next time we have one of these tragedies, inevitably we will, and you happen to be so unfortunate enough to know the person that's being accused of the crime, do us all a favor and don't get on TV the next day and be like, I lived next to him for 32 years. I never could have seen this coming. Maybe you should be locked up for 6 months. I find nothing more disrespectful. You never could have seen it coming. I've never met anyone in my entire life that I couldn't wrap my brain around the fact that they are capable of awful things. Literally no one.
He is so right. Like, I'm all about energy. You know what I mean? If your energy is good, I don't care what race you are. It doesn't matter. I don't, whatever. What culture you are, don't matter. If your energy is off, we're done. That's just pretty much what it is. So I agree with him on that.
My mom could blow up a nursery. If you put me on TV the next day, I'm
sorry. He just, yo, he's out of here.
Completely honest with myself, I'd be like, I can fucking see it. No, it makes sense. Sometimes when I was a kid, I'd come home from school, she wasn't happy to see me. I think she hates children.
Oh, no.
Ladies, know that every man you're sitting next to tonight, if you could get into their head and see every thought they have ever had, you would immediately pull out a gun and blow your head off. Because trust me, they're capable of anything. All day long, every day, nothing but twisted, weird, awful shit is just going round and round and round.
If this is true, put the eye emoji in the comments. We don't want to embarrass anybody, but I feel like I'm going to put my eye emoji in the comments too, because, you know, I got some thoughts that go through. You know, I'm actually about to do a whole other channel about some twisted stuff because I feel like people talk about it. I like to hear about it.
And what do you do at night? You snuggle up next to him because you're so happy that you're not alone. And I think that says more about you.
He crossed the line.
By the way, I do love this country. We're the only place with any diversity. The entire planet's segregated. You realize that when you watch it.
Yo, that is some. That is deep, what he just said. We are the only country that is diverse, and everywhere else will be considered segregated. Like, that's crazy. Like, if you agree, right, that's crazy in the comments.
International sports. Like, I was trying to watch the World Cup, despite hating it. I get it, soccer's the most popular sport on the planet. That's because half the world can't afford AC. And that's about how long you have to run just to get tired enough to fall asleep in these godforsaken countries.
Oh, man.
You ever try to gamble on soccer? What's the over-under, 0.5?
Oh, man. Ooh,
how much
man.
Time's left? It's a secret. I'm out. But we have diversity. Other teams don't. Or if you look at the Olympics, you look at our U.S. gymnastics squad. We have an Asian girl, a white girl, a black girl. Look at the Chinese squad. Any guesses?
Man.
Did you guess exclusively Chinese bitches? Yeah, that's all that's ever been on that team. That's all that will ever be on that team. And they wonder why they're not getting golds anymore. Well, you better get a Harlem in China.
Oh, man. I love how he can gradually just defend everybody in one sitting. It's like, how does he do this? He's like the definition of offensive. And I love it. I love it.
You think snapping together iPads all day is tough? It is.
Oh, man.
It's not as tough as it used to be. Now they have suicide nets around their building so they can jump out, bounce right back. Sorry, boss, just need some fresh air. You ever try to gamble on soccer? What's the over-under, 0.5?
Oh, man. Ooh,
how much
man.
Time's left? It's a secret. I'm out. But we have diversity. Other teams don't. Or if you look at the Olympics, you look at our U.S. gymnastics squad. We have an Asian girl, a white girl, a black girl. Look at the Chinese squad. Any guesses?
Man.
Did you guess exclusively Chinese bitches?
Oh, man.
Yeah. That's all that's ever been on that team. That's all that will ever be on that team. And they wonder why they're not getting golds anymore. Well, you better get a Harlem in China.
Oh, man. I love how he can gradually just defend everybody in one sitting. It's like, how does he do this? He's like the definition of offensive. And I love it. I love it.
You think snapping together iPads all day is tough? It is.
Oh, man.
It's not as tough as it used to be. Now they have suicide nets around their building so they can jump out, bounce right back. Sorry, boss, just need some fresh air.
Wow.
Back to making Americans more stuff? You got it.
Oh, man.
This is a tough joke to do as a white comedian, but here goes. Because where this country is now, from where we came from, is pretty remarkable. There's nothing more shameful in our country's past than slavery. Okay, that's horrible. But I've grown up in a generation where I've idolized black people my entire life. They are better at everything. So the fact that we pulled off slavery, I've already said it's awful.
Oh, man. He's good.
That's off the table.
He's good.
I'm just saying, it's kind of neat. I mean, at any point, they could have been like, you know we can just run away, right?
Man, he's going. going there. He's going there. And I like that. Like, you got to be willing to go there. You know what I'm saying? And he went there. And it's not about, you just have to have a sense of humor. If you don't have a sense of humor, you're not going to understand, you know, these comedians that I've been tapping into. You know what I mean?
And you will never catch us. And if you do, we will beat the living shit out of you. Right. That's about how well that joke should go over.
Oh,
there's a
man.
Fine line between appreciating the sarcasm and, ooh, this feels like a rally. And you did well. That's a joke I do not do everywhere. That's a joke if the audience gets a little too excited, I shut it down. You start hearing a couple yee-haws, trouble's a-brewing.
This is so, this, yo, he's hilarious, yo. He's hilarious.
As soon as yee-haw hits a certain octave, hate crime in T minus 10, 9.
Oh, man.
The unemployment rate in our country is around 6.5%. I'm told that's pretty good. I could care less. I wish a president would have the balls to say what I'm about to.
Oh, 10%
of Americans don't deserve jobs. Good night. Like, that's a number I can get my head around. Of course, there's exceptions to that. That's not who we're talking about. But if you don't think 10% of Americans are lazy pieces of shit, then you have never traveled anywhere.
Wow.
Because the number that blows me away is that over 90% of Americans have jobs. Who the fuck is hiring you, morons?
He is excessive.
Because I wouldn't.
Wow.
The sense of entitlement, everyone thinks they deserve more than they have. No one's content. Young kids, I won't even talk to them anymore because you parents have done such a bang-up job. If I meet one more kid and ask him what he wants to do when he gets older, and he replies, I'll be famous like you, I'm going to kick him in his teeth.
Yeah, I don't teach my son to be famous. I teach my son to be happy. You know what I mean? As a parent, you want to just tell your son to be happy or tell your kids to be happy. You know what I mean? You shouldn't push anything on them.
Never going to be famous. Never. You have no chance. I didn't get here because I work hard. I have a gift from God. Everybody gets their 15 minutes of fame, buddy. Excuse me? That's an average. Yeah, that's zero for you, zero, 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 20 years, zero, 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 zero. Everybody gets 15 minutes. You know Andy Warhol was on drugs when he said that, right?
Wow.
He didn't think he'd be quoted for the rest of eternity, let alone taken seriously as an artist.
Fun fact, my uncle is Jean-Michel Basquiat.
You ever go into like a cute local cafe and an artist has their work for sale on the walls? Has anybody ever not walked up, looked at the price and gone, who the fuck do they think they are? Just once, I'd like to walk into somebody's home and be like, wow, that is a beautiful piece. Where did you get it? And they're like, oh, funny story. I was getting a spinach wrap the other day for lunch, and I had $750 burning a hole in my pocket. And I was like, hey, guys, unbolt this from your urinal and get it into my living room. You know what the unemployment rate in China is? Neither do I, because I'm American. I'm fucking stupid.
Wow.
It's got to be low, right? Those people get up at 3 a.m. to practice the violin for 4.5 hours. Then they work on math for 12 hours, and whatever's left, they're ninjas. If you think for 1 second we will ever catch up with them, you are out of your mind. Just sit at home and be patient until they take over. And quite frankly, they deserve our country. I go, oh shit, China's here. Do we take off our shoes? How does this work?
So, man, this is my Daniel Tosh reaction. I mean, I think it's clear to know that I actually think he's hilarious. Like I said before, I like how he crosses that line. And I like how he's not scared to say what's on his mind. A lot of the things that he actually said on there were actual truth. And, you know, the sarcasm that comes behind it, I guess, is what makes him. If you guys have any suggestions on what else I should react to him on, please let me know in the comments. And, yeah, make sure y'all subscribe, hit the top bell. I'll see you on the next one.